think my name is Chui Phan. Jan asked me to be here just to basically share my experience from a couple of the boot camps that I did. I basically attended the rehab boot camp back in November 2016. So thank you for your time, and I'm hoping to kind of give you some really good experiences with the actual boot camp itself, in addition to some good experiences that I've learned along the way with some of the projects that I've been working on. So let me start with kind of giving you a little bit of background regarding myself. I have basically a bachelor's and a master's in computer science. I've been working in the space for over 20 years now. The last 15 years, I've been self-employed, you know, with my own software company. We basically have a software package that we license and offer to the federal government. So besides the federal government, we also have been moving into state and local and commercial customer base as well. So how did I get into real estate? I think one of the benefits, I guess, with just kind of being in this area for so long and having my own IT business, I was able to buy properties along the way for places that I use personally for my company or for me personally. As I grew, basically I just rented out some of those properties to others and kind of move on to something else. So kind of like my experience, up to the point before I took the boot camp last year, I had three rentals in Virginia. The two in Old Town, which are residential, and basically one that is a commercial office building. And I also brought on another property in Frederick, Maryland as well, which is now a rental that I have up there. It's on a two-year lease with a family. But really the reason why I took the actual boot camp was I wanted to learn a little bit more in detail regarding the flipping, the wholesaling process, because I kind of felt that real estate long-term would be a good way for me to diversify for my retirement. So I'm going to come back just to kind of give you my experience with the actual boot camps themselves. But let me kind of explain what happened after the boot camp and how I kind of progressed, once, I graduated from the boot camp itself. So after graduation, I started looking around for deals, different opportunities that are out there. I personally had trouble finding good deals with wholesalers. I submitted around 15 offers through MLS, and I just couldn't get any of them. So people were just basically overbidding what I was basically willing to pay for. So I started to do direct marketing around January of 2017, and I got lucky to actually have found a seller up in Germantown area. And that ultimately became my first flip. So let me just kind of walk you through the details of that particular deal real quick. So I basically had purchased the property for around $141,000. The rehab total was $43,000, and I was able to sell it for $235,000. So my net profit minus royalty fees, closing costs, was approximately $33,000 for approximately 4 months of work, basically 2 months of rehabbing work and 2 months of actually having the properties listed before it actually got sold. There's also another 2.5 months of actual marketing that I had to do before I even got the property under contract. So altogether, it was probably a seven months endeavor that I went through on that particular deal. But it was a good experience. I learned a lot. I was kind of fortunate that I didn't really come across any major issues, foundation issues, roof issues, things of that nature that really affected my numbers and my estimation. Really the only thing that I learned from that experience with Germantown was mainly the appraisal process. There's just certain things within the appraisal process where you don't get any kind of extra credit that applies towards the market value of your property. So, I spent around $7,000 to actually update the HVAC, hot water heater, and it really didn't really add any value to the actual, sale price at all. In general, I think you just got credit for having something that works or not work. what it really did was it actually helped you basically sell the property quicker with any other similar properties out there that may not have a newer HVAC or a newer hot water heater. So that was kind of like a learning experience. You know, having said that, you know, I think it was a good thing just to get those things updated for the next buyer. They appreciate you for it. And, you know, if you're going to be in this business for a long time, you want to make sure you deliver a good product compared to your competitors out there. So new kitchen, you know, new hot water heaters, you know, new HVAC, new roof if you have to is probably the way to go, because those are things that a typical buyer would typically ask for as well. Okay, so what else can I tell you? So my experience with the bootcamp, let me just kind of go back to that. The bootcamp was great. It was a two-day endeavor. I've learned a lot. I think what it really did in terms of helping me was to make me more confident in the transactions that I was basically getting involved with. So I kind of knew, you know, basically some things to look for, some things to plan for. Some things to ask and work with, you know, the sellers around. It also, you know, kind of gave me a little bit of foundation around like the templates, the purchase agreements, you know, the contracts that, you know, you get from going through the bootcamp, the estimation worksheets as well for actually estimating the costs, you know, the holding costs, the interest, the loans, things of that nature, the rehab expenses. All those are very valuable tools that you're going to get from the rehab itself. And really, you know, I think the last cool things that I really benefited from the actual bootcamp was access to the vendors and the contractors, which were phenomenal, because not only do they give you, you know, investor rates, they are actually a part of this network that really extends the training, and they actually help me better understand what I need to do, how to do it to actually be successful as well. So they kind of extended Jan's training out to the field where I'm actually working with his contractors, and they're kind of giving me guidance on, you know, the best products that I can pick and choose, the best designs that I can go with. And that was a big plus for me, because at least on the Germantown opportunity, there were certain things that I wanted to do which were considered old designs. Quinn, who was my contractor, you know, really helped, you know, change my perspective to do things that are much newer, more modern, that actually created that buzz to get people to actually buy the property as well. So one thing I forgot to mention, the property was listed 2 times on MLS, and it was only on the market for 2 days total. We actually have offers literally after 1 day on market each time. The first time it was listed, there was a buyer financing issue, so that fell through. We listed it again, and we got an offer 1 day after on market. So technically only 2 days on market for that particular property. I know a lot of people I speak with, their biggest concern is that there's probably it's going to be a down market, you know, in the stock market, the economy, and specifically the real estate market. You know, I think that's true, but I don't think that's going to probably happen until after 2019. Why do I think that? Assuming that we're going to have tax reforms, you know, that's going to probably kick in towards the end of this year, which is going to apply into your tax filing for 2017, 2018, and so on. I think the tax reforms, the revenues that consumers are gonna get from savings in taxes is gonna help to further fuel the economy for at least another, you know, couple years, in my opinion. So I don't think we're at the high end yet of the economy. I think there's still a lot of opportunities out there. It might slowly go down a little bit. However, I think if you make the right purchase price, you're gonna probably do well in the long run, even if the economy were to slip a little. So don't be worried when you hear naysayers say that. I would say, just take action, you know, and you know, there's no better time at the moment that we're at today. Thank you for your time.